Taiwan claims China is planning to impose a no-fly zone north of the island. Taiwan's defense ministry says the no-fly zone would fall within the country's air defense identification zone, about 85 nautical miles north of its shores. It expresses alarm over the plan as it could impact international aviation. Chinese Foreign Ministry spokesperson Wang Wenbin asserts he is unaware of this plan, but Japan says it has already been notified by China about the planned imposition of the no-fly zone, which will be happening next week.
Chinese President Xi Jinping tells his military to train for actual combat. Xi says the military should be ready to defend China's territorial sovereignty and maritime interests. Xi's comments came as tensions in the region worsen, sparked by Beijing's recently concluded military drills around Taiwan. China has also been vocal about its opposition to the expansion of a military defense cooperation between the Philippines and the U.S.
The U.S. reaffirming its commitment to its decades-old Enhanced Defense Cooperation Agreement with the Philippines. U.S. Defense Secretary Lloyd Austin says Washington will pour in some $100 million to develop new and existing EDCA sites that are accessible to American troops. He also bears an agreement to work on a security assistance roadmap with the Philippines.
In the face of coercion and gray zone aggression, Secretary Galvez and I agreed to redouble our efforts to strengthen our combined ability to resist armed attack by modernizing our armed forces. We also discussed near-term plans to complete a security sector assistance roadmap to support the delivery of priority defense platforms over the next 5 to 10 years.
President Marcos has said the four new EDCA sites, mostly situated in the northern Philippines near Taiwan, will not be used for offensive attacks. But Philippine Foreign Affairs Secretary Enrique Manalo says the function of the EDCA sites are still open to discussion.
So I don't think we're really at any stage yet to answer how they might be used. They're still open to discussion. But I think we have already reached an understanding that the basic elements of these sites would be, the basic purposes of these sites would be to address humanitarian disaster-related events, to increase and improve interoperability and training of Filipino and American assets, and also to be in a position to improve interoperability and perhaps respond to other types of security challenges.
The Manila City Prosecutor's Office orders the release of the two student activists who joined Tuesday's anti-Balikatan protests outside the U.S. Embassy. John Gabriel Magdibay and Joanne Pagkaliwanagan were taken by the Manila police for illegal assembly, allegedly committing vandalism and resisting arrest. But the city prosecutor explained the complainants failed to show photos or videos to prove the accusations. The prosecutor also referred the charge of resisting arrest for further investigation due to lack of evidence.